7.
October 7, 2017.
This is a case referred by a friend who's a vet but not practicing vet. So it's not possible for Dr. Daniel to handle the case because the vet who referred her to Toa Payoh West specifically mentioned my name. So now this is the dog. I can see this is a beautiful Shetland Collie. 1 year, how many months? 8 months old. Now the main complaint is actually ticks. Ticks. Small ticks. The owner used Revolution, but she discovered small ticks. And just now the other video showed those are very small baby ticks. And Revolution has been used for a long time, so sometimes it's not effective to prevent the small ticks from sticking onto the body. Now there are drugs. There are two types of drugs, or three types. One type of drug, anti-tick drug. The ticks cannot attach to the body, the skin. There's another type that the ticks can attach to the body. So nowadays the latest one is to use tablets once a month or once in 3 months. And they have their advantages and disadvantages. Advantages would be, of course, convenience. Disadvantages sometimes is can be quite risky in the sense that some dogs are said to have died after eating the tablets. But this is very uncommon, but still there's a risk. Then the other way is to use a wash, a vertical wash. I recommend put the dog in the sink, in the bathtub, and then put the dog in and then pour the vertical wash or the anti-tick wash on the way, rub into the skin to kill all the small ticks. And then the paws also. Rub it into the paws or the anti-tick wash. So about half an hour. Then the eyes, put eye ointment to protect the eyes. Then the ears cover with the cloth. Cover the cloth so that the tick wash won't go in. And then you must check whether the ticks are inside. Some of the ticks are inside the ears. So that one you have to pick up the ticks. So in other words, there are two ways of tick control in Singapore. One is a wash, and one is applied on the skin. There are three ways. The other one is oral, the mouth, goes through the mouth. So the mouth one will be tablets and quite effective. Okay, now I'm coming to the test for the tick fever. So there are two tests. One is the Babesia antibodies. Okay, taking a drop of the test. And the other one, the other rabbit test kit is for the four diseases. Canifor, Lyme disease, Anaplasma, Ehrlichiosis, and what's the other one? There are four diseases, so Ehrlichia, Anaplasma, Lyme disease, heartworm, yeah, the four tests. So it's quite good in the sense that they check whether they have the diseases or not. So this covers the ticks. Now I'm talking about the main complaint also is the ears. You can see sometimes the dog tilts the head. Sometimes the dog tilts the head except for the last 2 weeks. So the owner is concerned. So now I just check the ear by palpation. See, it's painful, okay? And the other ear, I just palpate the lower ear. Look, it's painful, no? Don't control the dog. It's painful. So there's something deep inside the ear. Now I use a scope. Ear scope. Normally should be a long nozzle, long one. But come. Now the dog won't allow me to check because it's painful. For 1.5. But I can check, see whether there are any mites on it. It's painful, okay? So let me see this side. So the problem is not on the upper part of the canal, is deep in. So I just check any ulceration, any ear mites. But this side is okay. This side the dog is not so, but still it doesn't like it. And this is the ear scope. So you use a ear scope to help you to check any bleeding, ulceration, and it looks okay here. You can see, it looks quite okay. Oh, this side is not so painful. Can get it? Okay. Okay, anyway, just show the ear scoping now. Okay. So I will do ear irrigation. So there will be some pain deep in the horizontal canal. I do ear irrigation to clear. Okay, so very good. So after that, after the ear irrigation, then what's the next one? We do a blood test for health screening. We take blood test for health screening. Health screening normally just to get a baseline. Okay, blood test for health screening. And so this is a health screening blood test. This one is a Babesia and heartworm test, rapid test kit. So these are different. Okay, these are two different things. And finally, as I do the ear irrigation, I have to do it under sedation because you can see the dog is not too happy with touching the ear. So I've done the sedation, and at the same time, the owner requested the dental scaling. Actually, it's a back teeth. Is it tartar on the back teeth? Huh? Other than that, you can see the brownish tartar. There's some gingivitis as well. You can see there, the gums are inflamed. So on this side as well, come. You can see the tartar at the back there. Just a brown stain, but not much. So it's just a slight dental scaling will do. Okay, that ends the educational video. So to prevent ticks, you can either use one of the three methods. Topical stop spot on, oral, the tablets, or the wash. So the tablets are the latest introduction. One is for 3 months called Bravecto, one is a NexGard, is monthly. Now, the other prevention is also avoid those park areas where there are a lot of dogs going there for exercise. Especially near your house, you know that the main owners like to bring the dogs there for exercise. Then the other one is I would recommend where to put here, where to put so that when they go out to walk, the ticks don't latch onto the toe. So they walk, they go out exercise with the booty. And you can see sometimes when you come back check for ticks, you can see that there are baby ticks in between the paws, or even big ticks in between the paws. So after exercise, you have to check in between the paws and under the paws, which is quite troublesome. Every time, you see, because it goes out every day, you check here as well. And many owners don't do it because it's a lot of work. It's a lot of work to do all this. So the other way is shave it off, shave the hand off, and then you can see the ticks latching onto the paws. This is the first contact. When you go to the parks, the ticks normally come to the paws as the first contact because the dog is standing on the ground. Okay, so that's the end of the educational video. I will start doing the ear irrigation and dental scaling, which will not be videoed. Thank you.